And the fires are howling way down in the valley tonight. There's a man in the shadow with a gun in his eye and a blade shining no so bright.
Meatloaf, ce qui signifie en français tas de viande, a connu la gloire en étant Eddie, le rocker obèse du Rocky Horror Picture Show. Et puis, à la fin des 70s, il a sorti une bombe en 33 tours, Bat Out of Hell, un album qui est resté plus de 10 ans dans les hit-parades aux USA. Meatloaf est de retour avec un clip stylé façon La Belle et la Bête et un album musclé, Bat Out of Hell, tout. Meatloaf, let's go.
Because the audience is standing there going, bravo, bravo, more, more, more. It was like wacky. They call what we do bombastic, over the top, self-indulgent. They're right. I mean, all those terms, they're absolutely correct, you know. Anything that most people would think of as negative, we think is positive, so. It's emotionally correct. It is emotionally pure. All the world's a stage and all the men and women merely players.
I'll never lie to you, and that's a fact. But I'll never forget the way
he always
you
said
feel
to me,
right,
you know, Bill Shakespeare would have loved you. He would have had your name in his plays if he'd have been alive today. So, as far as Shakespeare concerned, Meatloaf is a very legitimate name, even though some of the English probably wouldn't agree with you. But he always said Bill Shakespeare would love your name. So I thought he wanted, I figured they would not want to use Meatloaf when I was doing Shakespeare, but they did. And it, you know, it was like Raoul Julie and Mary Beth Hurt and Meatloaf and As You Like It, and then, you know, Ron Silver and all these people, and so it was pretty wild. I had done a play in Washington, D.C. at the Kennedy Center, and I'd been there for 6 weeks. And the play had closed the night before. I arrived back in New York, had not seen my apartment for 6 weeks, opened the door, put my bag down, walked over, opened my curtain. The phone rang, picked it up. Hello, is this Meatloaf? Yes, it is. This is da-da-da-da-da. We'd like for you to do a play in L.A. called the Rocky Horror Picture Show. When can you come? Now? And then an hour and 45 minutes later, without unpacking my bag, I closed my curtain, picked up my suitcase, walked right out my door, and was gone for another 9 months. But I was in a movie called Out of Bounds, and I got shot between the eyes. And so they put this little thing on your forehead, this little explosive kind of thing, where it, boom, and you get shot. That's pretty wild, because you really feel it. You really feel that go, you know, and there's some guy pointing a gun at you, and all of a sudden you do this, and it's just like, whoa. As long as the wheels are turning, as long as the bars are... My example was the French director Cocteau's Beauty and the Beast, 1948. And I said to him, have you seen that? And he went, no, so I gave it to him. I said, here you go. I mean, Francis Ford Coppola took a lot for Dracula from that piece as well. The world's a stage and all the men and women merely players.
No, I won't do that.
I'm gonna eat.